the way I imagined it, oh, I was imagining it more frenzy and with less skyscrapers, with less earthquakes, with less rain, but not with so kind people, and like, and also I could walk around like so safely with no worries at all. And I always also thought that since I arrived here, but it's a story that I already told three times, I don't know if I have to tell it again or not, but when I was a kid I used to play to an NBA game, that was not NBA, it was to 3-on-3 basketball video game where all my friends always used to take France, US, Argentina, and always used to take the Taiwan team. I don't know why, but it was just like by that, the idea of taking that. And it was very good actually in that video game. So when I arrived here, I thought like I would have seen lots of people playing basket around, but it wasn't really like that, so I was kind of disappointed. And yeah, the thing like that struck me more was all the skyscrapers like just right by side, the tiny houses. And I think it's very fascinating, that thing. And I was also fascinated by the decreasing numbers close to the red light at the stops, because I didn't understand what's the use, but it's like, it makes me worry. It's 3, 2, 1, ready to go. Like, it's something that we don't have in Europe, but I think it's better, because it would be like, but it's 2, 1, it's me. So, and no more beautiful women. And that pretty much is.
<笑>就是他对台北的印象原本想象的是可能更混乱一点，然后更少的高楼大厦，以及很少就是不会有地震，他没有想到有地震这件事，但让他碰到非常幸运。然后他来到这边之后觉得这边的人大家都很亲切，然后非常的友善，然后他也非常就是觉得台北是一个非常非常安全的城市，他可以就是到处乱走，然后都不用担心被抢或遭小偷。然后他对台湾的第一个印象其实是从他小时候的一个篮球游戏开始，就是那时候大家都会选可能比如说美国或者是阿根廷的人来当他们的那个国籍，但是他永远都是选台湾那个，那是对他对台湾第一印象，所以他觉得台湾人感觉超爱打篮球，但是他来到这里之后发现，哎，好像还好。然后对，就是除了那些高楼大厦之外，他也看了很多小，就是小比较小、比较老旧的那些房子，然后他很喜欢它。然后他觉得印象很深刻的是关于那个红绿灯。因为他们在欧洲并没有那种会倒数的小人，然后也不会就是3、2、1的时候要逼你那边一直跑，但是他觉得这还蛮不错，至少有个东西在提醒你说，哦，好，要红灯了这样子。然后还有就是台湾的女性都非常漂亮，这样。
谢谢，谢谢，真会说话啊，谢谢。好，我们也请我们战地的剧组来大合照，麻烦大家靠近一点，谢谢，谢谢导演，谢谢。